We're all done. And is Chad Johnson done in the search for love? That is the question. The Bachelor alum is on this famously single show. We'll get to that in a minute. Welcome here. Here's the thing. You know this. They portrayed you on The Bachelor pretty much as this crazy villain.
Right. No, yeah.
And do you feel that was at all who
I mean,
you are?
You know, I did all the stuff. So, I mean, you know, what wasn't showed in that show was basically like why I did all this stuff. You know, it wasn't, you know, in the show's best interest to show like me being nice or everything. It made it way more entertaining just to show all the crazy stuff I did.
But as you're watching that and right. Okay, you I did it. Are you thinking this isn't a complete picture? I, you know.
Well, for me, you know, it was hard for me to watch it and really know what people were thinking because I knew, you know, what had happened in the scene before. I knew why I said something or I knew why I flipped out. And, it, you know, it made it look like I just went off the, you know, handle. But in reality, there was like 8,000 things that happened that, you know, pushed me to that point.
Right. Okay. So with this Bachelor in Paradise, you're familiar right. with this whole scandal surrounding it.
Yeah,
do you have
yeah,
an opinion
no.
about it? What's your thought about it?
You know, I only know what I've read. I've not right. really talked to anybody. So, I mean, whatever happened, you know, I try and stay out of it just because that's a, you know, touchy situation. But
well, the thing that's interesting to me is given your own experience with the show.
Right.
So I don't know if we put this in percentage terms or how we just define it. This is what really happened to you. And this is what we saw on TV. You know what
right.
I mean? Are,
mm-hmm.
And are they not related to each
no,
other?
No, the story is all there, but there's just it's just like little bits. Like it may show somebody saying something, having a conversation or annoying you for 10 seconds when in reality it happened for 8 hours. You know, so it will show the actual story. It's just not to the like level of which, you know, makes sense or whatever.
A lot of people think being on TV advances a lot of different things for them. Did this help
right.
your love life at all?
No, I
because
mean,
people saw you as kind of this jerk.
Yeah, no, it's made it, you know, I think the one thing that was real with me, like on The Bachelorette was, you know, my sense of humor. And so all the crazy stuff, you know, yeah, people know like he's willing to get crazy. But like when they meet me in real life, you know, I'm pretty nice to people. And so I think it's helped, you know, just for the main thing, because, you know, girls kind of get now like who I am generally, my attitude. So it's made it super easy to like meet girls in real life, you know.
So that's a plus.
Well, they already know me.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
I don't have to do anything. It's just
right.
like I have to get to know them now.
Uh-huh. So you do this famously single show. How did you find that?
That actually, they reached out to me after the Bachelor in Paradise and just were kind of giving me another opportunity to either find love or kind of just show people who I really am.
And how did it go?
It went good. I'm not the bad guy anymore.
All right. Did you find love?
I did make a connection on the show. There was some dating for sure.
All right.
So
well, let's
it
see
almost
up.
Benefits Chad to stay single because yeah. of all
right.
this stuff, right?
Right. Yeah.
I mean, then if you
hook
in
up,
a serious
it's
relationship.
Yeah. I guess yeah. just do the Instagram thing if I hook up.
What's your real life profession before all this TV stuff happened?
Before this, I was a real estate agent.
Right. Are you still doing
mm-hmm.
that?
Not anymore. Now I'm a fitness entrepreneur. I sell diet and fitness plans online. I own a supplement company. And yeah, just kind of going that route.
All know, right. And all this stuff certainly doesn't hurt.
Yeah. No, not at all. You
all
know,
right.
I mean, show up in shape and that's pretty much all I got to do. Have a few drinks, go on some dates.
It's not at all dissimilar
to
my own experience.
Yeah.
You're famously single.
Next question. Who in this group do you think is the freakiest in bed?
Callum.
I like you. Good answer.
Callum, okay, Chad?
I'm gonna say New York.
Okay. All right, Ronnie?
Such I feel like Tiffany target. Would teach a freak how to freak. You know
100%.
What I'm saying, girl?
Yeah, yeah, totally.
Tiffany, who do you think?
Me.
Okay. Embracing
it. Owned
it. Embracing it.
Cheers to that.
All right, so that was the speculation. Was there ever a definitive answer?
Of who was the freakiest?
Yeah.
You know, I didn't see a whole lot of stuff go down in the house. Everyone was pretty chill. But
right.
I mean, there were like hotel rooms rented at some points and stuff, so I don't know exactly what all went down.
Okay, well, yeah. maybe things did. Famously Single premieres, it'll be this Sunday, June 25th at 10 on E. Chad, nice to meet you.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks so much.
You
thanks,
well.
Chad.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.